Namaskar. I am Dr. Anchit from Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, from the Faculty of Physiotherapy and Diagnostics. We are continuing our sessions on neurological conditions, and the condition we are going to pick today is facial palsy. Facial palsy is due to the damage in the facial nerve that supplies the muscles of the face. It can be categorized into two based on the location of the pathology. One is the central facial palsy, that is due to the damage of the above facial nucleus, and second is the peripheral facial palsy, that is due to the damage of the below nucleus, below the facial nucleus. The eighth cranial nerve has its nuclei in the pons and takes a rather winding route before exiting the skull through the stylomastoid foramen. It then passes through the parotid gland, splitting into five branches: temporal, zygomatic, buccal, mandibular, and cervical. Causes can be idiopathic infection, Ramsey-Hunt syndrome, Lyme's disease, congenital, and in rare cases it can be otitis media, multiple sclerosis, Guillain-Barré syndrome, etc. Risk factor can be diabetes, pregnancy, infection of the ear, upper respiratory tract infection, and obesity. Appearance or the clinical features is inability to close the eye, inability to move the lip, example into a smile or pucker. At rest, the affected side of the face may droop, the lower eyelid may drop and turn outward. That is called atropion. Effects is that it causes difficulty in eating, drinking, as lack of lip seal makes it difficult to keep fluids and food inside the oral cavity and it falls down. Reduce clarity of speech as the labial consonants, that is B, P, M, V, F, are all lip sealed. Dryness of the affected eye. Differential diagnosis may come between upper motor neuron lesion and lower motor neuron lesion. Diagnosis can be done through nerve conduction studies, CT or MRI. Outcome measures can be noted through linear measurement index, facial disability index, lip length and snout indices, and 5-point scale. Management, medical management. Bell's palsy are treated with corticosteroids given within 72 hours of onset, and this can be accompanied by antiviral medication. Patients are at high risk of corneal ulcer may be offered oculoplastic surgery to protect the eye. Physiotherapy. Neuromuscular retraining can be done. Electromyography and mirror feedback is helpful in educating the patient about his posture, about exercises. Topical electrical stimulation helps in muscle stimulation. PNF techniques help in strengthening. Kabat technique and mime therapy. Evidences have shown that physiotherapy has given a good response in Bell's palsy. Several exercises like blowing of the air and movements of the cheek, filling air in the cheek, have been helpful. And also speech therapy, reading newspapers out loud, speaking as much as possible, have been helpful in facial palsy. So this was a brief about facial palsy. I hope the session is clear. In case of any doubt, put in a comment. Thank you. Namaskar. I am Dr. Anchit from Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, from the Faculty of Physiotherapy and Diagnostics. We are continuing our sessions on neurological conditions, and the condition we are going to pick today is facial palsy. Facial palsy is due to the damage in the facial nerve that supplies the muscles of the face. It can be categorized into two based on the location of the pathology. One is the central facial palsy, that is due to the damage of the above facial nucleus, and second is the peripheral facial palsy, that is due to the damage of the below nucleus, below the facial nucleus. The eighth cranial nerve has its nuclei in the pons and takes a rather winding route before exiting the skull through the stylomastoid foramen. It then passes through the parotid gland, splitting into five branches: temporal, zygomatic, buccal, mandibular, and cervical. Causes can be idiopathic infection, Ramsey-Hunt syndrome, Lyme's disease, congenital, and in rare cases it can be otitis media, multiple sclerosis, Guillain-Barré syndrome, etc. Risk factor can be diabetes, pregnancy, infection of the ear, upper respiratory tract infection, and obesity. Appearance or the clinical features is inability to close the eye, inability to move the lip, example into a smile or pucker. At rest, the affected side of the face may droop, the lower eyelid may drop and turn outward. That is called ectropion. Effects is that it causes difficulty in eating, drinking, as lack of lip seal makes it difficult to keep fluids and food inside the oral cavity and it falls down. Reduce clarity of speech as the labial consonants, that is B, P, M, V, F, are all lip sealed. Dryness of the affected eye. Differential diagnosis may come between upper motor neuron lesion and lower motor neuron lesion. Diagnosis can be done through nerve conduction studies, CT or MRI. Outcome measures can be noted through linear measurement index, facial disability index, lip length and snout indices, and 5-point scale. Management, medical management. Bell's palsy are treated with corticosteroids given within 72 hours of onset, and this can be accompanied by antiviral medication. Patients are at high risk of corneal ulcer, may be offered oculoplastic surgery to protect the eye. Physiotherapy. Neuromuscular retraining can be done. Electromyography and mirror feedback is helpful in educating the patient about his posture, about exercises. Topical electrical stimulation helps in muscle stimulation. PNF techniques help in strengthening. Kabat technique and mime therapy. Evidences have shown that physiotherapy has given a good response in Bell's palsy. Several exercises like blowing of the air and movements of the cheek, filling air in the cheek, have been helpful. And also speech therapy, reading newspapers out loud, speaking as much as possible, have been helpful in facial palsy. So this was a brief about facial palsy. I hope the session is clear. In case of any doubt, put in a comment. Thank you. Namaskar. I am Dr. Ranjit from Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, from the Faculty of Physiotherapy and Diagnostics. We are continuing our sessions on neurological conditions, and the condition we are going to pick today is facial palsy. Facial palsy is due to the damage in the facial nerve that supplies the muscles of the face. It can be categorized into two based on the location of the pathology. One is the central facial palsy, that is due to the damage of the above facial nucleus, and second is the peripheral facial palsy, that is due to the damage of the below the facial nucleus. The eighth cranial nerve has its nuclei in the pons and takes a rather winding route before exiting the skull through the stylomastoid foramen. It then passes through the parotid gland, splitting into five branches: temporal, zygomatic, buccal, mandibular, and cervical. Causes can be idiopathic, infection, Ramsey-Hunt syndrome, Lyme's disease, congenital, and in rare cases it can be otitis media, multiple sclerosis, Guillain-Barré syndrome, etc. Risk factor can be diabetes, pregnancy, infection of the ear, upper respiratory tract infection, and obesity. Appearance or the clinical features is inability to close the eye, inability to move the lip, example into a smile or pucker. At rest, the affected side of the face may droop, the lower eyelid may drop and turn outward. That is called ectropion. Effects is that it causes difficulty in eating, drinking, as lack of lip seal makes it difficult to keep fluids and food inside the oral cavity and it falls down. Reduce clarity of speech as the labial consonants, that is B, P, M, V, F, are all lip sealed. Dryness of the affected eye. Differential diagnosis may come between upper motor neuron lesion and lower motor neuron lesion. Diagnosis can be done through nerve conduction studies, CT or MRI. Outcome measures can be noted through linear measurement index, facial disability index, lip length and snout indices, and 5-point scale. Management, medical management. Bell's palsy are treated with corticosteroids given within 72 hours of onset, and this can be accompanied by antiviral medication. Patients are at high risk of corneal ulcer may be offered oculoplastic surgery to protect the eye. Physiotherapy. Neuromuscular retraining can be done. Electromyography and mirror feedback is helpful in educating the patient about his posture, about exercises. Topical electrical stimulation helps in muscle stimulation. PNF techniques help in strengthening. Kabath technique and mime therapy. Evidences have shown that physiotherapy has given a good response in Bell's palsy. Several exercises like blowing of the air and movements of the cheek, filling air in the cheek, have been helpful. And also speech therapy, reading newspapers out loud, speaking as much as possible have been helpful in facial palsy. So this was a brief about facial palsy. I hope the session is clear. In case of any doubt, put in a comment. Thank you. Namaskar. I am Dr. Anchit from Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University from the Faculty of Physiotherapy and Diagnostics. We are continuing our sessions on neurological conditions, and the condition we are going to pick today is facial palsy. Facial palsy is due to the damage in the facial nerve that supplies the muscles of the face. It can be categorized into two based on the location of the pathology. One is the central facial palsy, that is due to the damage of the above facial nucleus, and second is the peripheral facial palsy, that is due to the damage of the below the facial nucleus. The eighth cranial nerve has its nuclei in the pons and takes rather winding route before exiting the skull through the stylomastoid foramen. It then passes through the parotid gland, splitting into five branches: temporal, zygomatic, buccal, mandibular, and cervical. Causes can be idiopathic infection, Ramsey-Hunt syndrome, Lyme's disease, congenital, and in rare cases it can be otitis media, multiple sclerosis, Guillain-Barré syndrome, etc. Risk factor can be diabetes, pregnancy, infection of the ear, upper respiratory tract infection, and obesity. Appearance or the clinical features is inability to close the eye, inability to move the lip, example into a smile or pucker. At rest, the affected side of the face may droop, the lower eyelid may drop and turn outward. That is called ectropion. Effects is that it causes difficulty in eating, drinking, as lack of lip seal makes it difficult to keep fluids and food inside the oral cavity and it falls down. Reduce clarity of speech as the labial consonants, that is B, P, M, V, F, are all lip seal. Dryness of the affected eye. Differential diagnosis may come between upper motor neuron lesion and lower motor neuron lesion. Diagnosis can be done through nerve conduction studies, CT or MRI. Outcome measures can be noted through linear measurement index, facial disability index, lip length and snout indices, and 5-point scale. Management, medical management. Bell's palsy are treated with corticosteroids given within 72 hours of onset, and this can be accompanied by antiviral medication. Patients are at high risk of corneal ulcer may be offered oculoplastic surgery to protect the eye. Physiotherapy. Neuromuscular retraining can be done. Electromyography and mirror feedback is helpful in educating the patient about his posture, about exercises. Topical electrical stimulation helps in muscle stimulation. PNF techniques help in strengthening. Kabat technique and mind therapy. Evidences have shown that physiotherapy has given a good response in Bell's palsy. Several exercises like blowing of the air and movements of the cheek, filling air in the cheek, have been helpful. And also speech therapy, reading newspapers out loud, speaking as much as possible have been helpful in facial palsy. So this was a brief about facial palsy. I hope the session is clear. In case of any doubt, put in a comment. Thank you.